Today we discuss about four-bar chain, Grashof's law, class 1 and class 2 mechanism, and how to identify the nature of the mechanism and all. First we have to discuss about the four-bar chain. The four-bar chain is the most fundamental of the plane kinematic chain. Basically it consists of four rigid links which are connected in the form of quadrilateral by four pin joints like A, B, C and D. The link that make complete revolution is called the crank. Here A and B is the crank. Next, the link opposite to the fixed link, the coupler. The opposite to the fixed link is called the coupler. Here BC is the coupler. The last one is the fourth link, call it as lever. The fourth link, CD is the lever. Okay. Here AD, fixed link, call it as frame. AB call it as crank. BC call it as coupler, CD call it as lever. Here fixed link, frame, crank, here coupler and lever. Okay. Next we discussed the Grashof's law. The Grashof's law, it states that a four bar mechanism has at least one revolving link if the sum of the largest and the shortest link is less than the sum of the length of the other two links. Here one more time, so the sum of the longest means L and the shortest link is less than the other two links P and Q. If the mechanism satisfies the Grashof's law, then the mechanism under inversions are belongs to the class 1 mechanism. Class 1 mechanism, that means the summation of shortest and the longest link is less than the other two links P and Q. It is called a class 1 mechanism. Class 2 mechanism, if the mechanism not satisfy the Grashof's law, then the mechanism under inversions are belongs to class 2 mechanism. That means the shortest link, the summation of shortest link and the largest link is greater than other two links P and Q. It is called a class 2 mechanism. Next, inversion of mechanism. Inversions, what is inversion? Different mechanism obtained by fixing different links of kinematic chain are known as the inversions. Different mechanism obtained by fixing different links of kinematic chain are known as the inversions. If you take link AD fixed means, you can get crank, double crank mechanism. Link AD, the shortest link fixed means, you can get double crank mechanism. Similarly, AB fixed means crank rocker mechanism. Similarly, BC fixed means double crank mechanism. Now we discuss about what are the inversions in a 4-bar mechanism. It is a table for 4-bar chain inversions. First in the link, and the link shortest link is fixed. The class 1 mechanism can get a double crank mechanism or crank or rotary to rotary mechanism. Similarly, class 2 mechanism, we can get a double rocker mechanism. Next, adjacent link to the shortest link is fixed, we can get the class 1 mechanism, crank rocker mechanism. The class 2 mechanism also double rocker. Okay. Next, third case, opposite to the shortest link is fixed, so we can get double rocker mechanism for class 1 mechanism. Class 2 mechanism double rocker. So three cases can get class 2 mechanism double rocker. Okay. So now we discussed the shortest link fixed. See the image here, shortest link fixed, the shortest link is AB fixed, we can get double crank mechanism. Okay, AB fixed, shortest link fixed, here double crank means AD and BC, two links are act as a crank. See, let us see the model. It is the shortest link fixed here, AD and BC act as a crank. Now the AD fixed, okay, we move the crank mechanism. It is my model for double crank mechanism.
Next, adjacent link to the shortest link is fixed. We can get double rock, crank rocker mechanism. Here, see the frame here. Adjacent link to the shortest link. Adjacent link to the shortest link. So the DA fixed. Okay, it is the shortest link. Adjacent link to the shortest link fixed. So we see the model. So adjacent link now fixed. We can get a different mechanism. See, it is the model for crank rocker mechanism. Next, opposite link to the shortest link is fixed. So opposite to the shortest link, opposite to the shortest link is fixed. So we can get a double rocker mechanism. See the model. So opposite to the shortest link is fixed. So here we can get double rocker mechanism. Okay. Different link fixed. Finally, in the class 2 mechanism, get all the mechanism double rocker, double rocker, double rocker. Shortest link fixed, double rocker mechanism. Adjacent link to the shortest link fixed, double rocker. Opposite link to the shortest link fixed, double rocker mechanism. The inversion means different mechanism obtained by fixed different links of kinematic chain are known as the inversions. Now identify the nature of the mechanism. One problem number 1, 2, 3. Okay. The Grashof's law already said summation of shortest and longest length longest link is less than the other two link P plus Q. Here shortest link in the problem number 1, shortest link is 5. So longest link 9. So 5 plus 9. Next other two link 7 plus here. S is shortest link, longest link 9. Here P Q. Okay. Other two link P Q. So apply this equation. Here shortest link 5. Okay. Longest link 9. Similarly 7 plus 8. Okay. 14 here. 15. So obey the Grashof's law. So the shortest summation of shortest and longest link is always less than the other two links. So obey the Grashof's law. It belongs to class 1 mechanism. Okay, first problem, obey the Grashof's law. So class 1 mechanism. Second problem, similarly here shortest link is S is equal to 4, longest link L is equal to 7. Here P is equal to 6, Q is equal to 7. So shorter 4 plus 7, 6 plus 7. So here 11, 13. Here also obey the Grashof's law. So belongs to class 1 mechanism. Second problem also belongs to class 1 mechanism. Next, third problem. Which one is the longest link? 10. L is equal to 10. Okay. Shortest link 5. So S is equal to 5. So 5 plus 10. Other two link P is equal to 7. Q is equal to 9. 7 plus 9. So here 15. Here 16. So this equation also satisfy the Grashof's law. So it is belongs to class 1 mechanism. So three problem belongs to class 1 mechanism. Here first problem, shortest link fixed. So shortest link fixed, you can get class 1 mechanism. So double crank mechanism. Therefore, the shortest link fixed. Therefore, it is a double crank mechanism. Like the double crank mechanism. Similarly, second problem also shortest link fixed. So same class 1 mechanism, here class 1 mechanism, shortest link fixed. So So first one, double crank mechanism. Okay, here write like this. Therefore, it is a double crank mechanism. Third category, class one, same class one mechanism. Here, shortest link, okay, shortest link opposite to the shortest link fixed. Okay, opposite to the shortest link fixed. Here in the table, opposite link to the shortest link is fixed. You can get double rocker mechanism. Okay, write like this. Therefore, it is double rocker mechanism. So finally, identify the nature of the mechanism. Three problem we can get for first one, double crank mechanism. Second one is the double crank mechanism. Third one is double rocker mechanism. Fourth problem, here which one is the shortest link? S is equal to 5. Here longest link L is equal to 9. The equation is S plus L less than P plus Q. Here anyone P, here Q. So S is equal to 5, L is equal to 9. Next 6 plus 7. So here 14, here 13. So it does not satisfy the Grashof's law. So it is belongs to class 2 mechanism. So therefore, here they show the table. Here opposite link to the shortest link or adjacent link to the shortest link. So second category, adjacent link to the shortest link. So class 2 mechanism, double rocker mechanism. All the categories you can get double rocker mechanism. So therefore, the mechanism, nature of the mechanism is double rocker mechanism. Class 2 mechanism, therefore, can get the nature of the mechanism is double rocker.